Hey everyone, welcome y'all. In this video, I'm going to show you how to handle autocomplete Google Places dropdown in Selenium Webdriver. So first of all, let us see what is autocomplete Google Places dropdown. So sometimes you may see some kind of dropdowns where we can select the places or Google locations. Let me show you one example. Here I have a tuplex.com. When I go to live posting, and here you can see a small dropdown. And here by default, the value is autocomplete. Here you can see Toronto on Canada, which is by default, it is there. And if you want to change this value, you can just have another value. Let's say I'm searching for Toronto, and you can see a lot of suggestions are it is displaying. So this is basically places autocomplete dropdown. And these values are coming through API. So when I search for something, the API will be triggered and the API will get the data from the server and presenting here. And we cannot inspect these elements. This is a specialty of this dropdown. So we cannot inspect any of these options in this dropdown. And these options are dynamically coming from the server at the runtime. So whenever you find, if you send some search string here, the API call will be sending to the server and these selected values will come here. So this is called as autocomplete Google Places dropdown. So basically what is the specialty of the dropdown is internally, this is calling a places or autocomplete places API. If I just look at the another page here, this is Google Maps platform. This is one of the API which is used in the Google Maps. So in the Google Maps, we have an API called places autocomplete. And when I apply this API, when I use this API internally, the dropdowns will appear like this. So these are all autocomplete dropdowns, especially used for Google Places. When I search for something and nearby locations will be listed out in the options. So this is the actual API which is used internally for this particular element. So we cannot inspect any of these locations or options in the HTML code. So now we'll see how we can handle this. Okay. So for that, what you can do is let me open my Eclipse. And in my Eclipse, I already created a Maven project. And I already have pom.xml, which contains a Selenium Java dependency, which is also contains a WebDriver manager dependency. Now inside my package, I'm creating a new class. So I will name it as autocomplete Google Places dropdown. And let's take a main method and say finish. So here, first of all, we need to specify a WebDriver setup. I'll say WebDriver manager I'm using, WebDriver manager dot. So WebDriver manager dot, I'm setting up the Chrome driver dot setup. And once we have set up the Chrome driver, and then we have to create the WebDriver instance. So I'm creating WebDriver instance here. I say WebDriver driver equal to new, I'm launching Chrome driver. Now import this WebDriver and also import this Chrome driver class. All right, so once we have done this, I'm also trying to launch my application. I say driver.get, and here I'm launching this application homepage. So this is actual homepage I'm launching here. So once you launch the homepage, I'm just trying to maximize the page. I say driver.manage.window.window.maximize, which will maximize the application. And then what I will do is, I just want to click on this live posting. So inspect this element and I can write one XPath here. So this is basically inside this anchor tag. So I'm trying to write one XPath here / anchor tag, and which is having, which is having some attribute called, I'm using the text here because this is a link. So text equal to in the single quotations, I say live posting. Live posting. So search for it. Now it is pointing to exact element. Now I'm using this XPath to click on the live posting. Then we will get the dropdown. So I say driver.findElement by dot XPath, specify that XPath dot click. So this will perform the click action on the live posting, and then we will get the dropdown. So now we can just look at here. This is a dropdown. So here, how we can handle this. So by default, there is some value which is populating here, Toronto, comma, on, comma, Canada. So I want to search for some other value. So first of all, we need to clear this value inside this element. So if I just inspect this element, you can just see one input tag for that. You don't see any options or nothing here. Inside even div, you never see any values or any auto suggestions. It will just give the input tag here. So this is the actual element, dropdown element. So I'm taking this ID, autocomplete ID, and go and inspect that element. Driver.find element. I say by.id, specify the ID. I'm getting this element into a variable. So I'm just say search box. And this is a web element. All right, so now import this web element. So once we have getting this search box element, then first of all, we need to clear it. So dot clear method I'm using. So which will clear the actual value, which is clear like this. And then we can search for the new value. So once you clear it, then we can search for, I say Toronto. So this is my search string. So now what I will do is take the same element and dot, I'm using send keys, and also I'm passing something called Toronto. This is the value which is passing. So once you pass this value, then what happens is, which will give you auto suggestions like this. And these suggestions we cannot inspect through XPath or any other locator. So what we have to do now is we have to do something here. We have to just click on down arrow key. So just observe what is happening when I click on the down arrow key. So which is selecting the first option and which is automatically populating in the input box. And then I'm pressing one more time down arrow key. And now it is selecting the second option. Now again, I'm clicking in the down arrow key one more time, second, the third option, fourth option, fifth option. So by using these arrow keys, we can just navigate between these options. Okay. So this particular facility I'm just trying to use. So for that, what I can do is I'm just trying to create one variable called text variable. So we need to write proper logic here. So I'm just taking a variable called text. I'll say string variable I'm taking, which is a TXT or text we can take. And this variable I'm trying to use it. So here, basically we cannot find how many suggestions are displayed here. If I just look at here, sometimes you may find three options, five options, six options. You don't know exactly how many options will be finding here. So we cannot find how many options here, but we can navigate from each and every option like this by pressing down arrow and upper arrow keys. So we don't know exactly how many times we have to repeat it here. So I'm just trying to start with the do while loop. So here we have to use a do while loop I'm using. And the condition I put here is I'll say while not text is empty I'm using. Text dot is empty. So I'll tell you what is the text contains. So this is a condition I'm applying. So not text is empty. Okay, this is a condition I'm using. Is empty is a method. Text is a string variable. Is empty is a method and then semicolon. So this is a do while loop I created. So internally in the do loop, what I can write it here, I'm taking this element called search box dot send keys. So because I need to send some value in it. So send keys. So you already sent a value called Toronto, right? So as soon as you send a value Toronto here, then what happens is it will show you rest of the options. Now by pressing down arrow key, I'm going to each every element in this option, every option in this drop down. Okay, for that I can take the same element send keys, and here we have to press the down arrow key. For that I can pass one parameter called keys dot arrow underscore down arrow. You can just look at here dot arrow underscore down. So this particular parameter will be clicked on the down arrow key. So once you click on the down arrow key, then what happens is which will go to the first element like this. As soon as it is pointing the first element, it is already selected into the box. So now we can get this value. So how to capture this value is again, take the same search box and use one method called get attribute. Get text method will not get you. So only get text, get attribute value we can use. So I'm using get attribute of value. Get attribute of value. So what this will do is as soon as you click on the down arrow key, the first element is highlighted. So I'm getting that value and store that in the text variable. I'm storing into the text variable. So now we need to check the text variable is equal to our expected value. So whichever I want to select from this dropdown, I want to compare with. Suppose I want to select something called this one, Toronto, OH, USA, I want to select. So immediately what I can do is, just a moment. So Toronto. So when I search for it, I say Toronto, HO, USA. So this is the value I want to select from the dropdown. So what I can do is I can just pass that value in the equals method, if condition. So here text I captured. So then I'll put one if condition. If the text value dot equals, okay, dot equals. And what is the value I'm expecting to select? I want to select this particular one, Toronto, OH, USA. And inside this, if this value, text value, whatever we captured from the dropdown, if it is equal to this one, immediately what I have to do is take this search box dot, again, send keys. Here click method won't work. So send keys. And here directly we can say keys dot enter, keys dot enter we have to use. So because these are options are not a web element. So these options are not a web elements. We cannot apply any click method or get method, anything. So simply search box dot send keys method, just press enter. So it will be like this, guys. So if I pass something here, I say Toronto, I'm pressing on down arrow key. Now, if you want to select OH USA, as soon as you selected it, press enter key. Then it is automatically selected. Okay. So here, get attribute value will give you the text. If the text value equal to this one, then go and click on the same box. So once you press enter, this value will be selected from the dropdown. Immediately apply break command here. So as soon as your value is matching, then we have to come out from this looping statement. So break command will be used. So that's it, guys. So this is how we need to just write a simple loop statement. Let me repeat once again. So first thing what you have to do is we have to clear the box because this is autocomplete. By default, there is a value. And then we are passing the search string. And I'm taking one text variable so that I want to read individual values. What are the options are displaying? I want to read individual values. By going down or by pressing down arrow key, I'm taking individual values into the text. For that, I'm using this text variable here. So search box dot set send keys of keys dot arrows down. So this command will click on the down arrow key and then get the value from the text box, because as soon as you click on the down arrow, as soon as you do the down arrow like this, the values are populating in the input box directly. So I'm taking the value from the input box, not from these options, because get text, get attribute will not work directly on these options. So we have to use those methods from the input box itself. So I'm getting this value, get attribute of value into the text, and then comparing the text with this equals to, then send keys, and we have to press enter. So automatically the value will be selected. And as soon as the value selected, then come out from the looping statement. Suppose if the condition is not matching, then what happened? The condition will be verified. The text is contains some value. So text.isEmpty, no. So then it will go up and again continue the statements. So text.isEmpty is a method will return true if the text is empty. But here I'm saying not. That means the condition will be true. Then it will go up and get another text value here and again compare with. So this loop will repeat till your search value is matching with that option. And finally, it will select the value from the dropdown. So this is how we need to work with this special type of dropdown. So what I can do is I can also put some wait statement here after coming out of this break. I can say thread.sleep. I can just put here. Let's put 3000 milliseconds so that we will able to see exactly what is happening. Otherwise it will go very faster. So we can put implicit wait, but I'm putting white thread dots to be here. Just I want to show you how the options are selecting. So I'll keep this method in multiple places. So first of all, I want to clear it. Here I'll put and send keys Toronto. Here I'll keep 3 seconds. And after arrow down also, I'm just keeping here 3000. Just I want to show you how the navigation is working. So let me just execute this code now. So run as this is the expected value, which I want to select from the dropdown. So now run as Java application. Okay, now Chrome driver was started successfully and it is launching my browser and opening this URL. Then trying to click on live posting. Now we can just look at here. So first of all, it should clear that value in the from the dropdown. Yeah, now it is clear. It is entered my search text. Now just observe this. My arrow key is coming down slowly, one after another. So first to select it, Toronto on Canada and Toronto NSW Australia. Then it will go to the next one, Toronto OH USA. So as soon as it is matching, we apply the click action. Now it is selected. Right. So this is how we can just work with the dropdown. So this is a special type of dropdown. So those options we cannot inspect on the HTML code. And once the API call is done, so those options dynamically will be displayed. So this is basically called Autocomplete Google Places dropdown API. Somehow you can see these kind of dropdowns in your application. Then this is the way we can follow to select the options from the dropdown. Okay. So that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. In the next video, we will see a few more questions.